why do we need a parliament? What are the two houses of parliament? Answer, the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. What does EVM mean? EVM means electronic voting machine. How does the parliament session begins? The parliament while in session begins with a question or when were EVM used for the first time? EVM were used throughout the country for the first time in 2004 general election. What is a constituency? A constituency is an area whose voter elect a representative to legislative body. Who presides over Lok Sabha? Lok Sabha are the House of People with a total membership of 545 is presided over by the Speaker. What is the purpose of Parliament or what is the main function of the Parliament? Parliament enables citizens of India to participate in decision making and control the government. What is the principles of universal adult franchise? The principles of universal adult franchise means that all adult citizens of the country have the right to vote. How many members does the president nominate in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha? The president nominates 2 members to the Lok Sabha and the 12 members to the Rajya Sabha. Who makes the opposition party? The opposition in the parliament is formed by the political parties that oppose the majority party or coalition formed. The largest among these parties is called the opposition party. Parliament is the most important symbol of the Indian democracy. Explain. Parliament enables citizens of India to participate in decision making and control the government, thus making it the most important symbol of Indian democracy and key features of the constituency. Which house of parliament is more powerful with regard to financial matters and how? Lok Sabha is more powerful with regard to financial matters because money bill can be introduced in the Lok Sabha, thus it control the finance of the government. Give reason for the reservation of seats in parliament for a scheduled caste STES and SC and OBC. Some seats are reserved in the parliament for a SC and STs. This has been done so that the MPs elected from these constituencies will be familiar with and can represent Dalit and Adivasi interests in the parliament. Opposition plays an important role in democracy. Justify or what is the role of the opposition in democracy? Opposition parties play a critical role in the healthy functioning of the democracy. They highlight the drawback in various policies and programs of the government and mobilize the popular support for their own policies. What are the basic ideals of the democracy? The basic ideals of the democracy are the ideas of participation in decision making, the need for all democratic government to have the consent of their citizen. What are the major function of the parliament? The major function of the parliament are to select the national government, to control, guide and inform the government, lawmaking. Enlist the component of Indian parliament. The parliament of India is the supreme legislative body of the Republic of India. It is a bicameral legislature composed of the President of India and 2 houses, the Rajya Sabha Council of States and the Lok Sabha House of the People. State the demands of the Indian National Congress in 1885. The nationalists began to openly criticize the British government and make demands in 1885. The Indian National Congress demanded that there be elected members in the legislature with the right to discuss the budget and ask questions. What are the reserved constituency? What is the purpose behind such constituency? Reserved constituency are both constituency in which seats are reserved for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. On the basis of the population, this has been done so that the MPs elected from these constituency will be familiar with and can represent Dalit and Adivasi interest in parliament. How many seats should be political party acquire in Lok Sabha to have a majority? For a political party to form the government, they must have majority of elected MPs, since there are 543 elected plus 2 Anglo-Indian nominated members in Lok Sabha. To have a majority, party should have at least a half of the members, that is 272 members or more. Describe the coalition government, or what is a coalition government? Often times in the recent past, it has been difficult for a single majority or single political party to get the majority that is required to form the government. They then join together with the different political parties who are interested in similar concern to form what is known as a coalition government. How can all the citizens participate in the decision-making process of the government? Or how do people participate in decision-making in a parliamentary government? Or how does the individual give approval to the government? People would elect their representatives to the parliament, then one group from among these elected representatives forms the government. The parliament, which is made up of all representatives together, control and guide the government. In this sense, people through their chosen representatives form the government and also control it. Write one merits and demerits coalition government. Merit: greater policy scrutiny is prominent in coalition government, which could prove beneficial for voter. Demerits: conflict within the governance due to conflicting the ideologies of the two parties can make the government weak. How is a national government selected? Explain the way in which a political party formed the government. After the Lok Sabha elections, a list is prepared showing how many MPs belongs to each political party. For a political party to form the government, they must have a majority of elected MPs, since there are 543 elected plus 2 Anglo-Indian nominated members in Lok Sabha. To have a majority, party should have at least half of the number, that is 272 members or more. Write a short note on Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha, one of the most important function of the Lok Sabha is to select the executive. The executive is a group of persons who work together to important or implement the laws made by the parliament. The Prime Minister of India is the leader of the ruling party in the Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha, the House of People, with a total membership of 543, is presided over by the Speaker. How are the representatives elected to the Parliament in India? The Parliament in our country, or in our system, in the government, has immense power, because it is the representative of the people. Election to the Parliament are held in a similar manner, as they are for the state legislature. The Lok Sabha is usually elected once every 5 years. The country is divided into numerous constituency. Each of these constituency elected one person to the parliament. The candidate who is contest elections usually belongs to the different political parties. Once they elected, these candidates become the members of the parliament or MPs. These MPs together make the parliament. Why do you think our national government supported the idea that all adults have the right to vote? Our national movement supported the idea that all adults have a right to vote because in our struggle for independence, people from all walks of life participated. They came from various backgrounds and were united in the aspirations for a free, equal and independent nation where decision making would be in the hands of the people. The only way in which this would be possible would be through election, allowing common people a vantage point from where they can consent to and approve of a government that they have the right to choose. Write a short note on Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha functions primarily as the representative of the states of the India in the parliament. The Rajya Sabha can also initiate legislation, and a bill is required to pass through the Rajya Sabha in order to become a law. It therefore has an important role of reviving and altering the laws initiated by the Lok Sabha. The members of the Rajya Sabha are elected by the elected members of the legislative assemblies of various states. There are 233 elected members plus 12 members nominated by the president.